Hi, my name is Tel Koenderink and I'm the founder and master trainer of Novulo, where we help schools, teachers and parents create a better place for gifted children. Hey, what I want to talk to you about today is this entire talent, giftedness, IQ thing, because it really gets some people, you know, stuck in a place where I don't think they're helping themselves and they're not helping the kids either. And in Holland, there's even, because in English you've got gifted and talented, it's already kind of like a mixed definition. In Holland you've got hoogbegaafdheid, highly giftedness, which is a very specific term, which implies that it's very, you know, scientifically founded and very exactly diagnosable. And that I don't really agree with. Because if we look at the simplest model that is around, you know, the model by Ranzulli, which especially in Europe has been expanded a lot by Heller and Gagné and all these other models, which keep including more and more factors. But even if we take the simplest model that is around, Ranzulli's model, the three circles, above average ability, creativity, and task commitment. Well, what's the problem with this model is that it doesn't always show who you want to help. Because maybe you've got a kid who has an above average ability. He is talented in one way or the other. But probably, if you're like me, you've seen some of these gifted kids who are not doing squat. They're not doing anything. You know, you give them assignments, they're refusing. They say it's boring, or I don't know how to do this, or they're stuck. I wouldn't talk about task commitment there, and they don't appear very creative either. I mean, at most creative at trying to dodge assignments. But so, according to this model, this kid doesn't show gifted behavior. But if you take that as your definition, then you say, well, this kid is not gifted or highly gifted, so we don't need to have any educational facilities for him. And that's exactly the wrong way around. Because especially this kid who has this talent, who has lost all the other components from motivation to, you know, self-reflective skills and stuff like that, he needs our help. He needs our support to be able to bring that potential forward. And even within this above average ability, there's a challenge, because we usually measure this by IQ. But IQ is also like a big swamp. I read a book recently. At least the title is already awesome. IQ, a smart history of a failed idea. And it describes the entire history of IQ. And for some people, IQ is this like really divine measurement, which is completely absolute. There's nothing to doubt about and it's always correct. But that's simply not the case. You know, if you take the WISC, which is one of the most standard Wechsler IQ tests, it has a probability interval, which means that in 95% of the time, if a kid has an IQ of 130, which usually is associated with you know, giftedness, but what they're saying is there's a 95% chance that his IQ will be between 124 and 134. So as soon as you take that as a measurement, the kid needs to have an IQ over 125, you're already limiting yourself. So IQ isn't like the end-all and be-all, and I've guided several kids who scored, you know, under 100 on one IQ test, but over 130 on another one, because they were guided by a different person or in a different environment. So IQ isn't, you know, holy either. And the question is, what is the goal of your model? Because what I hope is that the goal of the model is to bring out the best out of a kid. And it shouldn't be this, you know, gatekeeper model. If you don't have all the three components, or if you don't have all the 22 components in the multi-factor model of Heller, then you're not allowed in. No, that's not what they're for. What they're for is to explain what are all the factors that we can influence and how we can help this kid so we can diagnose his or her problems and help him or her forward. So make sure you keep the focus on how to help kids forward. It shouldn't be an admission test, it should be a test for further development. So don't get hung up on, you know, is he gifted or not, or is he highly gifted or profoundly gifted, or is he in the right category. Focus on what are the educational needs of this kid. What are the challenges he runs into? You know, I usually use the model of the 7 challenges that I've defined, that I've seen most kids run into. But whatever model you use, look at what the kid needs and give it to him, whether he's highly gifted or not. Because that's what we should all focus on. the thing I always end with, bring out the best in yourself and in each other. So let's focus on that, bringing out the best in ourselves and all the kids that we get the privilege of guiding. Yeah? Let's do that. Thank you so much for watching. Bring out the best in yourself and in each other.